it's great, obviously, to come back and see familiar faces, people that help you out, like yourself and David Ward and teachers, obviously, down the corridors. It's always nice to bump into those people. So there's that element with the memories that go with it. But, you know, secondly, obviously, to see the talent the school's obviously got to be able to try and help, you know, the kids in the way that I was helped at that age, and to just, you know, if it's one thing they can take away from me from that particular session, then I think, you know, I've probably done a decent job, and you know, even if it's inspiring into cricket a little bit more, because you know, that's so important that we, you know, keep people interested in the game and grow it and make people better, and hopefully they enjoy it more that I'm here. Well, I suppose from an early age, you know, I was always fighting rugby and cricket, and the great thing about Whitgift is obviously, you know, facilities, level of coaching was, you know, second to none, really, probably better than what you would have got maybe at the county level. Certainly was here. We were very lucky to have yourself and David Ward, two guys who had played professional cricket and knew what it was about. You could instill probably the key fundamentals you need to enjoy the game of cricket and be successful at it. But then also, you know, being a school like Whitgift, you're playing competitive cricket against other schools, good schools, you know, and then as I got older, you know, we went more into detail with it, and we just tried to, you know, become better and better, and see how, you know, it wasn't like when I joined Whitgift, I was like, right, I want to be a professional cricketer. It was like, right, I'm going to play rugby, I'm going to play cricket, I'm going to play football, I'm going to play tennis, and cricket was just one of those ones alongside the rugby that just sort of, you know, came to the top, and then ultimately it was cricket that came out the winner. So fundamental in my sort of development, definitely. Whitgift has always had a massive sport element, and you know, but at the same time, you know, it was equally about, you know, making sure that, you know, I was studying away and not overlooking that side of things. You know, sport was always where my heart was, but at the same time, it was a great environment to grow up, and I think, you know, the grounding that gave me, and you know, the sort of the personality that I sort of have now is that I sort of feel like I'm very hardworking. I've got my feet on the ground. You know, I don't take anything for granted. And I think, you know, there were elements of that at the school. You know, we had a lot of hardworking kids, a lot of different ranging kids. You know, kids who were brilliant academically, and guys who had also grown up in harsh, you know, environments as well. So. It was a very broad spectrum of kids and staff, like the teachers. You know, we had some great rugby teachers to cricket teachers to academics. So it was a great sort of varied environment to grow up in. I think when I think back to, you know, I suppose it was, I was 10 years old when I joined, and I had a couple of loves. And they were, you know, sport and really sport, really. And I suppose, I think the story that when the headmaster interviewed me, he asked me what I was going to bring to the school. And apparently I said something like, well, I was reading your tennis results from the year, and you played 7 and won 3, and if I was here, you'd have won all of them, or something like that. Like, I think I was a pretty confident young lad, and I said something like that, and I think the headmaster loved it. And but I think, you know, if you're a young kid coming here, you look around and, you know, you see the facilities and you see my lads playing football out there, and the environment that, you know, and the feeling that you get when you walk through the gates. I think it was always, you know, we're in the middle of Croydon, but you walk in here and it feels like a special place, and I loved, you know, growing up in and around South Croydon, as well as where I lived over in South East London. So I think it's hard to put some finger on something, but when I was 10 years old, I just walked in and I saw the sports facilities and I saw how much they love sport and, you know, music and things like that, because I loved my music and I sung at Royal Albert Hall with a school and things like that. Like, it's just, you know, things like that I think are an amazing opportunity that Whitgift can offer you. And you know, I don't really know many other schools that offer you the variety that you know, that I, you know, that other schools can offer. So it was very lucky, and I loved it from day one, really.